Johns Hopkins invented modern medicine. Biomedical engineering is at the center. It's the engineering discipline of medicine. In the future, we will see the engineering of healthcare. Biomedical engineering will be at the heart of that. As a department that was founded in the medical school, we also are equally weighted in the Whiting School of Engineering, so we're unique at the university. Our tight integration allows us to be involved with clinical leaders throughout the university. And of course, these are the biomedical scientists who are making the markets in modern healthcare. Over the past 50 years, engineering has been about controlling the external world. What biomedical engineering is really about is controlling the internal world. So the opportunity to, you know, read and write to disk in the history of computer technology was a major breakthrough. But imagine the opportunity to read and write to your brain or read or write to your genes. And those are technologies that are being created by biomedical engineers, and they're going to change the way the world moves forward in the future. We're interested in really understanding the brain as a thinking machine, and so we want to understand how the structure of the brain and the function of the brain manifests in your behavior. We've been trying to characterize neurodegenerative illnesses such as Huntington's disease, Parkinson's disease, and Alzheimer's disease. And we'd like to be able to predict the onset so that we can have an impact on your future outcome. What excites me as the director of biomedical engineering is that Johns Hopkins is such a great university, and we have the greatest students and faculty in the world, and the opportunity to work with the best people in the world, to teach the best students who go on to lead disciplines all throughout the world, is so intellectually exciting. Johns Hopkins Biomedical Engineering essentially founded the field. We defined it in the 20th century, and what's so exciting about the future is that we have the opportunity to define it for the 21st century, and we're in the process of doing that.